How'd the Titan 115 HVLP do? Hi, I'm Ron Polk, designer of the Smart Wood Shop and a number of workbenches. If you want to get a set of my plans, you can go to thesmartwoodshop.com and you can purchase and download the plans right there. Okay, so I did a part one and a part two of the Titan HVLP, and the part three is to be me actually painting with it. Well, that video is in the can and it's to be edited and it's coming. But when I did it, I made it clear, as in all the other videos about it, I'm not a painter, I'm a woodworker, but I need to paint sometimes and I want to get professional results. In that video that's coming, you'll see that I'm playing with settings and whether I got a good result or not, it really was hard to tell in that video. So I thought I would jump ahead and put this quick one up and show you what I got. Piece of plywood, not sanded or prepped or anything. I was just adjusting the settings and changing the thickness of the paint, and I was wiping things with rags and getting some overspray. I was actually, this here, it was kind of cool. I did a straight spray with it in the round mode. It was pretty neat how much control I got after I worked with it. But when I was done with the video, I wasn't really sure what my results were going to be. So I had this one board that, after I got things sort of dialed in, this was my final attempt at my first use of it. And after it dried out, I'm really impressed. So I got a nice, durable coat, looks really good. It's really smooth. And again, this is just a piece of Moreland ultralight ply. I didn't sand or prep or anything. There's some writing on it here that I did, but really came out well. So I'm pretty impressed with that. So when you watch that third video where I actually spray, you'll see me spray this. And again, I wanted you to see the final results. It really turned out well, and I'm excited to get an opportunity to actually use it in a real world application. And I think when I get a chance, I'm going to spray my workbench and also my total station. So that's kind of what's going on. And I wanted to just give you this quick look and look forward to that video. As you all know, I'm in the process of a big project here with lots of little projects making up this very big project. And I'm working my way out of this space. The owner is moving back in and I'm getting it all ready for them to move back in. So, but I'm still trying to grab these videos. Plus now using this DJI Osmo action camera, I'm trying to catch things as we go. The audio, one of the great things about moving on from this space is this is an all concrete building, floors, walls, ceiling, everything is concrete. There's just no way for me to stop the echo. So I've spent a lot of dollars on microphones, and I have purchased software to help me remove the echo, but there's really no great way other than fixing it at the point of capture. Now, what I'm doing at this moment is I'm recording the audio with the Osmo Action, but I'm also recording it with my AirPods into my iPhone. And so I'm going to give that a shot in this video and see if that sounds any better. So you get a chance to see how it sounds using these, because this will be something that I always have with me, using for my podcast and listening to music and videos and things. So it'll be nice that I've got these microphones here, as well as I have a Zoom recorder, which I'll be using with the lapel mic. So hopefully get the sound when I'm out in the field and doing things to tie it in with the Osmo Action Mobile, which I think is pretty good. A lot of echo in this space, but we'll see how these do as well. So that is what is going on at the moment, and I wanted you to see the finished product. I'm very impressed. First shot, non-experienced. HVLPs are supposed to require the most skill of all spraying. It takes just time, putting gallons and gallons and gallons through your sprayer and adjusting until you get it right. And then once you figure it out, according to my painter, you can get the best job, the best atomized paint, the best finish, but it does take a little bit of skill. And actually, I have my painter who uses the same sprayer on site today. And when I was walking by his truck, I saw his sprayer in the back of his truck, just thrown in the back in the weather to see, you know, how beat up it looks. But yet the finished results, he's been using that sprayer on my job for years. And the finished result he gets with his experience is just absolutely drop dead gorgeous. So, you know, I'm confident that, yes, I'm inexperienced, but I'm going to put gallons and gallons through it. And being that that was my first attempt and it turned out so well, I'm pretty excited on the results I'm going to be able to get. So, hey, thanks for dropping into the Smart Wood Shop. Thanks for hanging out. Remember to subscribe and ring the bell so you know when I drop a new video. Most important, share the channel with others. Thanks for taking the time to watch. Have a great day.